have one of these in your garage, chances are you've left it on, you came out the next morning, and you heard it running. I've done the same way too many times and decided I was going to come up with a solution. So what I did was I bought a 110 volt timer, connected it to a double pole relay, and all I have to do is push a button. This one has 10 minutes, 30 minutes, 60 minutes, 2 hours, 4 hours, plenty of time for me to do simple tasks like airing up a tire. When I'm ready to use the air compressor, I simply push one of the selections on it and the air compressor will run. So let me show you how I did this. So let's rewire this. What we're going to do, I've already disconnected the input wire that comes from the breaker. I do have the quick disconnect that I have disconnected just to be on the safe side. I also have the main breaker turned off that comes to here. So this is 220 volts. It was into this switch here, which has the on-off switch. And then this also has the pressure regulator, which will turn the air compressor off once it hits the desired pressure. So I disconnected the source wires from here, and I'm going to build a relay system that will allow me to use a timer to turn that off and on. So let me show you how that's done. So I'm not going to bore you with the details. Basically, this is a 6x6 box. I took and cut it out with a Dremel tool and made it to where this timer switch would work in there. And then drilled two holes. This right here will end up going to the air compressor. And then the wire that comes from the breaker will go into this hole here. Since I already have that other connector and a cable there, I'm just gonna hook it into there. This is the relay. This is what happens. The timer relay, which works on 110, gives an output, and that's this black wire here, and it energizes this relay. When this relay is energized, it's going to pull down. When it's not energized, it lifts up. So right now, these connectors that are here and these connectors that are here are connected. When it energizes and pulls down, these connectors that are here will connect to these connectors that are here. So that's how you can pass your 220 volts from here to here or here to here, depending on which way you want it to be wired. Now, to energize this relay, in a normal situation, the way this timer works is you have your neutral and you have your hot, and then the hot is what's switched. Since this is 220 and I don't have a neutral ran to mine, I'm just using the ground on the opposing side. Technically, the ground and the neutral have the same potential. This probably would not pass code, but this is just in a garage shop, so I'm fine doing that way. If you had 120 volts nearby, you would be safer to run 120 volts into this timer relay, just like you would normally hook it up. And then your output, you would run into here, and then the neutral from your 120 volt side would go into the other side of that coil across the relay. In my case, I only have 220. I didn't run a neutral or the white wire, so I'm doing it this way with the ground. So I'm going to take and basically this is already wired up because I pulled it off for the video, but we're going to go mount it to the air compressor and get it wired up to the air compressor, and then we'll test it out. Okay, so we're back at the air compressor now. I actually had test fitted this onto the air compressor and went ahead and drilled me two holes right here. So I'm going to go ahead and screw this onto the air compressor. Get that on there. Get that one mounted, and then over here. Get that mounted. So now that that's mounted, we're going to take the wire that comes from the disconnect switch and go ahead and run that through this hole. Find our other side to the connector there and get that pushed through. Tighten that down. We'll snug that up. All right. So coming from the breaker, we've got 220 across these two and our ground. So we're going to hook all the grounds together. So we've got our incoming ground. We've got our ground coming out that's going to this wire here that goes to the air compressor. We have the ground that goes to the timer, which on the timer, I've just jumped across and went to the neutral. If you did have the neutral, obviously your neutral would go to this side here, and you would also take that neutral, and that's what would go to the other side of the relay, this switch here. So ultimately, this would be a ground, this would be your neutral will go there and there, and then, you know, you'd run your grounds to your compressor. So we're going to get these connected. And then we're going to take, these are our two inputs. So we've got, let's see, we've got our outputs already hooked up here. So our inputs are going to go one here. Not sure if you can see that or not. I'll show you in just a second. And then we're going to go so we've got the red that's going to this side of the relay and the black that's going to that side of the relay. Now, depending on your wires, you may just have two blacks. And then we've got over on this side, we've got our outputs. So we have our black and our white that comes out, comes into this wire here that we end up feeding into the air compressor switch. So before we get too far along, we have to power the switch itself. So we're going to use one side of that 220 to do so. That's going to give us 110 volts. So I'm just going to hook it to the bottom terminal there, which is the easiest for me to get to. Loosen the screw a little. And then turn that up. There we go. And then tighten it down. Make sure you have good connections here because there is a pretty decent amount of startup current. And if these connections aren't really good, eventually you're going to start arcing. There we go. So at this point, we're ready to close this up. Make sure that none of these wires get in the way of that relay because that relay does move. So I'm just going to kind of place that unit right there. And then we're going to get started over here on wiring into the compressor itself. So now we're going to wire this into the compressor itself. We're going to feed the wires through the little hole. Put our little nut back on. Get some of these wires out of the way. All right, and then we're going to take and snug that down. Perfect. And then we've got, we'll move these connectors around. We'll get them hooked up. But before we do, we're going to get this ground connected since it's down below and on the bottom. All right, we got the ground down. Then we can go ahead and put this cover back on. All right, let me go turn the breaker on and we'll test it. All right, breaker's on. Plug this in. And let's see if it works.